Today, the U.S. Department of State's Bureau of Educational and Cultural Affairs is launching an online partnership with the Google Arts and Culture platform to showcase the Cultural Heritage Center's work to protect and preserve cultural heritage around the world. The State Department works with international partners to preserve heritage and protect culturally important sites, objects, and practices. This community engagement spurs economic development, cultivates respect for cultural diversity, and further promotes U.S. foreign policy objectives. Since 2001, the U.S. Ambassadors Fund has worked with partners in over 130 countries to protect and preserve cultural heritage through more than 1,100 preservation projects.
I want to thank the government of Panama for being a leader, a partner on this issue, and for bringing all of us together for 2 days of what were productive talks, productive planning, and action. As President Cortizo and I discussed yesterday, the partnership between Panama and the United States is one of the strongest that we have in the Americas. Our countries work together every single day on the issues that matter most to our people.
Approximately two-thirds of all Ukrainian children have been displaced from their home. More than 5 million Ukrainians have fled their country. It's an absolute outrage. We've already welcomed tens of thousands of Ukrainians to the United States, and today I'm announcing a program, Unite for Ukraine, a new program to enable Ukrainians seeking refuge to come directly from Europe to the United States. This new humanitarian parole program will complement the existing legal pathways available to Ukrainians, including immigrant visas and refugee processing.
Deaf and hard of hearing diplomats represent Americans of every race, religion, background, and from every part of our country. People who use American Sign Language make up an important linguistic minority that enriches our country, our government, and our department. Last year, I appointed Ambassador Gina Abercrombie Winstamp to be our first Chief Diversity and Inclusion Officer. Together, we're working hard to make sure that the State Department is more equitable and accessible, including for deaf and hard of hearing employees. I think this is the first visit since the Russian aggression by a senior official of the Ukrainian government. Further evidence that a independent, sovereign Ukraine is going to be around a lot longer than Vladimir Putin. We continue to work to support Ukraine with the assistance that it needs, military, economic, humanitarian. We continue in coordination with allies and partners as well to exert significant pressure on Russia to end the aggression. And of course, we continue to take steps to shore up the defense of our NATO alliance.